So starting with the control chart method of quality control. So broadly there will be three ways which we can do quality control. First is using control charts. Then using acceptance sampling. And third is using design of experiments. So this is an offline, this is online quality control method. So that means that as during our production itself, there will be many stages of production, like task 1, task 2, task 3, machine 1, machine 2, machine 3, like that. And we will, during the manufacturing process itself, we will make changes in our process accordingly. So that as per our requirement, the product is manufactured. Design of experiment is before manufacturing. So this is during manufacturing or during production. This is before production. So what we do is, before the manufacturing phase itself, we design the manufacturing phase such that the output is maximized or productivity is improved. And acceptance sampling, this is offline quality control method, and this is also offline, but this is after production. So this is not a quality control method as such. We are just trying to limit the bad products which are going out of our plant, so that a good quality lot or good quality products only reach to the customer. So in that way we are trying to limit. So this is control chart method which we are going to study right now. So in control chart method, during production, whatever we have, so we record the dimensions of our product and which we want to limit in some range. So there is a limit specified by the customer that I want my product to be in this much range. So if he asks for 1 foot of scale, then he can say that 30 centimeter plus minus, he can tolerate a range of 0.01 centimeter. So this much error he is ready to tolerate, because this error will come because of manufacturing inabilities. We cannot perfectly manufacture a 30 centimeter scale. So this is the error. So this specifications given by the customer or the designer of our product are called as specification limits. So these are given by the designer who designs our product, or the customer who is going to use our product. And then second are control limits. These are specification limits and there are control limits. So control limits are completely based on how our process is able to manufacture. It has nothing to do with what they want. This is just an indication of how good our machines are to produce. So they can produce till the limit of 0.01 centimeter, or a limit of 0.001 centimeter, or a limit of 0.1 centimeter. So they are, these values are completely based on what our machine is able to do, and specification limits are just indication of what the customer wants or what is our aim of. Okay. And so in our manufacturing, there could be two types of variations which are possible. Some are random variations, others are non-random variations. So they are also said as causal variations. So the random variation occur by some random cause which we cannot detect easily, and causal variation have some assignable cause behind them. So since random variation we cannot find the cause behind them, they could be random also. So we cannot eliminate these variations. This will be there in our process itself. And some causal variations we can eliminate it, and we need to eliminate it. So the total variation can be reduced as much as possible. Then the causal random variation goes beyond control limit, then stop manufacturing and rectify. And non-random variation goes beyond control limit, then also stop and find stop the process of manufacturing. So I would define the control limits. So this CL, and these are specification limits, SL. So anywhere, whatever are we manufacturing, there could be some upper control limit, and there could be some lower control limit. Generally, the distances are equal, this distance, and they are equal to 3 times the standard variation of X bar, lower control limit. And we will generally use X bar here, and upper control limit and lower control limit. This could be mean, center line. This is center line. This is upper control limit, this is lower control limit, UCL, LCL, okay. So what does this mean is that once we have this type of control limits, upper control limit and lower control limit specified for our process, if our any product plots here, dimensions, these are dimensions, there could be some single dimension, multiple dimensions. So if it plots here, it is acceptable. If it plots outside the control limits, we need to stop the manufacturing, do some changes in our manufacturing process so that the next items fall inside our control limits. And this bandwidth is given because the machines cannot exactly produce at whatever our aim is. So this could be our aim. That should be the mean also of our manufacturing process, but there are limitations on our manufacturing process, hence we are giving some toleration on which we can produce. So these are bandwidth is given because of that, and the points which should plot inside should be following a normal distribution, something like this, normal distribution. So as we go away from it, it should reduce exponentially. Not exponentially, there is some other factor, but it should reduce drastically. So control chart are online quality control tool, design of experiment, DOE, is offline quality control tool, that is quality is inbuilt into designed products and manufacturing machines itself. And we let the random variation within control limit to exit because we cannot eliminate random variations, and then we don't let non-random or assignable variations even within control limit to exist. And there are rules to find this, or there are tests that we can find that there are assignable variations or not. So how do we determine that what parameters or what dimensions we should check? So there is one term, critical to quality. So a simple small part like a nut or a bolt will also have lot of parameters or lot of dimensions in them, but all are not critical to our quality. So we'll find out some critical to quality parameter, and we will only do this checking of the dimensions on those critical to quality parameters only. We'll not check all the parameters. And then there are two phases of quality control to charts. So first is start with some, we guess some control limit, figure out the points plotting outside control limit, and then find their cause and take actions, and then reduce the control limits. So once we have such type of points which plotted outside, we stop our manufacturing, we do necessary changes, and then we again calculate the mean of our product, mean dimension, and then upper control limit and lower control. We'll discuss how do we find this, and how our control charts useful is, they increase our productivity because we are not producing out of, or we are reducing the waste, we are reducing wasteful efforts, we are preventing the generation of defective items, then we are preventing unnecessary process adjustments. So like one would say that if our process the dimension is not at our aim, that is at the mean line, it is outside somewhere, then he will say that let's make the change to our process and bring this point towards the mean. But then if some next point which is going to be plotted here, that will go outside our control limit itself. So this change was unnecessary. So this type of study of control limits will reduce some unnecessary process adjustments. Fifth is, it provides diagnostic information. So it will help that even if all the points are inside our control limits, if they are on the single side of our mean, then there is some rule which we need to apply so that we can help. It will help us. There are rules. So we can judge the trends inside of our points correctly. And then it also gives information about process capability, how our process is capable, it should be more, it should be less, with respect to the specification limits. And then it can also help to find out the mean and standard deviation of our process, because generally the standard deviation of our process are unknown. So using such control charts, so R and S bar control charts help us to find out sigma, estimate sigma, not perfectly, but it will help us to estimate sigma. So generally the control charts are having control limits as plus minus 3 times the standard deviation of X bar, and for specification limits it is plus minus 3 times the sigma. So this is for the process, this sigma is process mean and this is sample mean. These are X bar are the samples mean, and hence sigma X bar will be samples standard deviation and this is process standard deviation. And so there are two cases. So if our spread is higher than what it is from the specification limits, our spread, the machines or the manufacturing process spread is so much, then it is required as per the specification limits, then the operator cannot do anything, while the management level has to take some actions and take some better equipments for manufacturing. While if our process mean is here, the aim, and currently the process mean shift to some other value, then this is the fault of an operator, and operator has to take the action. And how does the quality control help us, this control chart help to increase quality control, is we have some input parameters, we have some process, and then we get output, then we have next process, then we get another output. So when we get an output at some stage, we make the checks on those products and we give it to some black box. It will return that if we need to make changes to our input parameters or not. And range is defined as X max, whatever is the maximum dimension, minus the minimum dimension recorded. And when mean is not known, population mean is unknown, then if we have some m samples and xi bar are all the sample means, so x bar means the mean, so there could be 4 samples which we can take, so we will have 4 means of those samples. Each sample would have some n number of items, then the process mean can be estimated by like this. That's what here it is. So I have, and then we also will study about operating characteristic curve and average run length. Both are complementary things. And so this was central line, this is upper control limit, lower control limit, which are not same as specification limit, because you know that sigma x bar is equal to sigma by root n. So definitely sigma x bar will be smaller than sigma, and hence the control limits are generally less spreader, they are closer than the specification limits. and for the control chart of X bar, so we'll see this in next class also. So the control chart, so the center line will be X double bar, which we calculated here. Center line will be this much. Upper control limit will be X bar plus 3 sigma X bar, and lower control limit will be X bar minus 3 sigma X bar. Okay.